Hi everyone, this is KRB. In this video, we are discussing about how to construct an epicycloid. The question is, draw an epicycloid of a circle of diameter 50 mm, which rolls outside a circle of diameter 180 mm for one revolution. Also, draw a tangent and a normal to the epicycloid at a point 135 mm from the center of the directing circle. The generating circle diameter equal to 50 mm. Small d equal to 50 mm. And the outside circle of diameter 180 mm. Capital D equal to 180 mm. It means directing circle. Is it? So, Now I am discussing about how to construct an epicycloid. Now first of all, draw the diameter of the rolling circle. Diameter equal to 50 mm. I am taking radius equal to, the radius of the directing circle is 25 mm. I am taking radius equal to 25 mm as radius. Point C as center. This is the rolling circle radius. Now draw the rolling circle diameter. Now the circle divide into 12 equal parts. As radius, this point as center, cut the circle, both sides, this point as center again this point as center, cut the circle on both sides, and this point as center. Join these all the points. This circle divide into 12 equal parts. Is it? So in this, I am choosing, this is the point is base point. The point on the circumference of the circle, rolling circle, this is the point P. So here this is the point 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. This one is 12th one, that is the point P. This is the point P. Now draw the directing circle. This directing circle radius equal to 90 mm. Radius equal to 90 mm. So now I'm extending this line. How much it is? So 90 mm. From this point P, the distance equal to how much? 90 mm. Here too, here is 90 mm. This is the point O. So now calculate the angle. The angle small r by capital R into 360 degrees. Small r equal to 25 mm by capital R equal to 90 mm into 360 degrees, that equal to 100 degrees. Draw. Now mark the 100 degrees by using protractor. Inside of the angle 0, 10, 20, so on up to 90, and this is the 100. Draw a line from point center of the directing circle to this point. Extend like this. Extend like this. Now draw an arc or locus from the points. See here, I am taking radius O to P as radius. This is the locus 2L. Locus 2L. Again, point 1. Similarly, it is passing through 11 and 1 on same path. Again, at 2, 2 and 10 both are the same path. Again, 9 comma 3. Draw the locus 9 comma 3. Again, 4, 4 comma 8. So, again 5 comma 7. Then 6 locus 6. Draw the locus 6. And also draw the center of the generating circle. Center of the generating circle. This is center of the generating circle. This is very, very important. Remember. So this is the center C of the generating circuit. Now this angle, the included angle is how much? It is 100 degrees. This angle divide into, this circle is divided into 12 equal parts. So this total angle divide into 12 number of equal parts. See, 100 by 12, how much? Now this total angle divided by 12 number of equal parts, because the circle, generating circle divide into 12 equal parts. So 100 by 12 equal to 8.3 degrees. So each and every division divide into 8.3 degrees. So here 25 plus 25 plus 25, 4 25s are 100. See here 25, this is the first one, and another 25 is the 50, and another 25 is the 75, and this one is the 80. And again, see 8.3 plus 8.3 equal to 16.6, approximately 60, in between 16 and 17 we have to mark. And another 8.3 is a 25, 24.9. So here the 1, 2, 3, this is the division 3, this is the division 6, and this is the 9, and this one is the 12th division. Is it? So now I'm marking 8.3, almost I mark approximately 8. So this is the 10th one, this is 9th one, it is 8th. And second division is 16.6, means in between 16 and 17. In between 16 and 17, like this. Then again here 5, 6, 7 and 8. Another one is 16 and 17. In between 16 and 17. 5, from here to here 5. 6, 7, 8. This is 15, 16, 16 and 17. In between 16 and 17. Similarly, 5, 6, 7, 8. This is 15, 16 and 17. In between 16 and 17. Now, draw a straight line from O to this division, each and every point to the center line. To intersect the center line. This is the center line. This intersection point is C1. Similarly, This is C2. This is C3. And so on up to C12. These are the centers C1, C2, C3 and up to so on C12. Now taking radius equal to CP as radius, CP as radius, C1 as center, cut the locus 1, cut the locus 1. This is the locus 1, 11. So cut the locus 1, 11 arc. Now same radius C2 as center, cut the locus 2. This is. And C3, same radius, cut the locus 3. C4, cut the locus 4. And C5. And C6. Again, C7. See, 5, 7, locus 5, 7. Like this. C8. C9, C10, C11, and this is the C12. So this is the 12. Now we got the locus of point P, the epicycloid curve. So now join these all the points, draw a smooth curve. The obtained curve known as epicycloid. Now give the notations. Locus of P, this one is P1, P2, P3, P4, P5, P6, P7, P8, P9, P10, sorry, P10, P11 and P12. So draw a tangent and normal to the curve at a distance 135 mm. Now I am taking radius equal to 135 mm as radius. See here, 135 mm as radius. Point O as center. This is the directing circle center. So now cut the this curve. Cut the curve like this up to here. Is it? So this is the point P. Here we got point P at this point. Now we draw a normal and tangent to the curve. Join. Now I am taking radius equal CP as radius. CP as radius. Point P as center. Point P as center. Cut the center line. Cut the center line. This point is known as N. This point is named as N. Now join N to point O, join point O. So this NO intersect the directing line. So this point is X. This is the point X. This point is known as, name it as N. Now join N to P is a straight line. N to P is a straight line, draw a line. So this is normal to the curve and tangent is always perpendicular to the normal. Normal and tangent is always perpendicular to the curve. So this is our obtained tangent. This is T, T dash is a tangent. This N, N dash is the normal. These two are perpendicular to the curve. So this distance from P to, so this is the radius R. question. So this is the radius 135. This is the radius 25 from here to P2X, and this to P2O is 135. And the radius of the directing circle, directing circle equal to how much? 90. And this is the diameter, rolling circle diameter equal to 50 mm. Now this is our required or obtained epicycloid. This is our obtained epicycloid.